الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره، نعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة، خلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا، يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، فإن كل محدثة بدعة،
كل بدعة ضلالة،
وكل ضلالة في النار، وإنما توعدون لآت وما أنتم بمعجزين. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. The peace and the blessing of Almighty Allah be with you all. I'd like to welcome you all for continuation of our series 100 Advices by the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. This morning, inshallah, we're going to read segment or advice number 81, which in page number 55. عن أبي سعيد الخدري رضي الله عنه قال خرج معاوية على حلقة في المسجد وقال ما أجلسكم؟ قالوا جلسنا نذكر الله. قال الله ما أجلسكم إلا ذاك؟ قالوا والله ما أجلسنا إلا ذاك. قال أما إني لم أستحلفكم تهمة لكم، وما كان أحد بمنزلتي من رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم أقول عنه حديثا مني، وإن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم خرج على حلقة من أصحابه فقال ما أجلسكم؟ قالوا جلسنا نذكر الله ونحمده على ما هدانا للإسلام ومن به علينا. قال الله ما أجلسكم إلا ذاك؟ قالوا والله ما أجلسنا إلا ذاك. قال أما إني لم أستحلفكم تهمة لكم، ولكنه أتاني جبريل فأخبرني أن الله عز وجل يباهي بكم الملائكة.
أبو سعيد الخدري reported that معاوية went to a circle in the mosque and said, "What makes you sit here?" They said, "We are sitting here in order to remember Allah." He said, "I adjure you by Allah to tell me whether you are sitting here for this very purpose." They said, "By Allah, we are sitting here for this purpose." Thereupon he said, "I have not demanded you to take an oath because of any allegation against you, and none of my own rank in the eyes of Allah's Messenger, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, is the narrator of so few hadith as I am. The fact is that Allah's Messenger, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, went out to the circle of his companions and said, 'What makes you sit?' They said, 'We are sitting here in order to remember Allah and to praise him, for he guided us to the path of Islam and he conferred favors upon us.' Thereupon he adjured by Allah and asked if that only was the purpose of them sitting there. They said, 'By Allah, we are not sitting here but for that very purpose. Whereupon the Messenger, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, said, I am not asking you to take an oath because of any allegation against you, but for the fact that Jibril came to me and informed me that Allah the Exalted and Glorious was talking to the angels about your magnificence. Sahih Muslim.
Alhamdulillah. Here is the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam when he came out and he sees a Sahaba sitting in the masjid. After their salah, they remain seated there. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam questioned his companions, "What are you doing here? Why you are gathering? What's going on?" Say, "O Prophet of Allah, we are here remembering Allah and remembering and mentioning His favor upon us, that He selected us, make us among the Muslims." So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam asked him, "Are you sure this is the only reason that you are gathering here?" So they swear, they give oath, say, "O Prophet of Allah, by Allah, this is the only reason that we sat here." The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told them, he did not doubt in, he is not doubting what they're saying. He has no question or have a reason to suspect them. But the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam been given the revelation, been informed that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala proud with those people, that because they sitting remembering Allah, mentioning the favor of Allah upon them. So we can see the importance of being in the masjid. The Sahaba, the salah is over, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is gone, and when we come back again, he sees that they're still sitting there. What's he doing? Basically, somebody studying, somebody reading Quran, somebody remembering Allah, making dhikr, somebody mention, say, "Look, how we used to be, how Allah bless us, how many other people that stray, they don't know about Islam, how many people been flavor." So they recognize the favor of being a Muslim. And this was something so dear to them. And here is the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam telling them, he have no doubt about this. He have no reason to suspect what they saying. But he telling them how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was proud with those people that said and did this. And this is to show us the importance of being in the masjid, remembering Allah, remember the favor of Allah, and how that Islam brought them to be brothers, and how they used to hate each other. Everybody, all what you think, can blot in the Islam is the only thing can unite us. It's not a color, it's not a name, it's not a school of thoughts, it's not a school, you understand, half a place, nothing. When we come in the masjid, we are here nothing but brothers in Islam. Doesn't matter what country you're coming from, what school you went to for, how, what kind of car you driving. All these things, understand, you leave it outside before you come here. Why? Because there is no favor greater than the favor that Allah made make you Muslim. Mm-hmm. And the blessing of this teaching, anything that you're talking about, behavior, economics, politics, whatever, Islam have something to say about it. So now you have one thing called As-Sirat al-Mustaqim. You don't have to borrow from here, and today you understand you are an Arab, and tomorrow you are Afro-American, and next day you are eating like a Chinese people. No. You have one color, okay? You have one sirat. You have one direction. Subhanallah. This is ni'mah. It's a blessing. And look also at the same time how many people walking back and forth in the street day and night. They stray. They don't get to know who is Allah. Somebody worshiping a cow, somebody worshiping a monkey, somebody worshiping his own philosophy, somebody worship none, and people going crazy. We have to see the ni'mah, we have to see this blessing that Allah choose us. And this is something that we should be proud of it. Nothing else to make us proud, you understand, or making us better than others, other than Islam. And a person have to be realizing this. Because when you know the value of something, now you're going to protect it more. There is a difference between, you understand, having $2,000 watch and a watch that you got it from the flea market. You understand? The way how you guard it, the way how you understand, always making sure that you don't lose it. So we need to see Islam. We need to see the ni'mah of Allah. Everybody have eyes, everybody have ears. But how many people using their eyes and their ears? They're using it for music, using it for gossiping, use it for different things. But how many people are utilizing and seeing the gift of Allah making you a Muslim? So it is very important that we get to see the ni'mah. Get to see that Allah has selected us among millions and billions of people. Subhanallah. And if it's not the guidance of Allah, we could not be guided. So when the Sahaba sat and talked about this and said, remember, brother, we used to understand to gambling and we waste all this money, and after this we steal the money to come to gambling again. Look how Allah blessed us. Look, you understand? We went to jail, but how Allah make us a reason for us to be Muslim. Now we Muslim. And we talk about it. Talking about the favor of Allah over you. Okay? And now that you recognize the blessing. Okay? So now, in return, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He doesn't need our ibadah. Huh? But the Prophet had informed the Sahaba that Allah is proud of us. And that Allah, exactly like what we're sitting now doing this. Exactly like this. Alhamdulillah. And we ask Allah to make us among those people that He's proud of them. And that mentioning their names in the Mala' al-A'la among the angels. Say, look, how many people sleeping? And this 5, 10 people sitting there in the mosque. Look how many people are snoring. And this brother sitting listening to the khatira. To Hadith Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. May Allah make us among those people. Amen. It's a great ni'mah. And we have to feel it. We have to understand. For you to be working, understand, until 1 o'clock in the morning, and after this you try to be here for 6 o'clock in the morning to make the prayer. It's a ni'mah. You know how many Muslims, look, the mosque is empty. How many people are in the masjid? So you have to always to feel and to recognize the blessing of Allah over you. And talk about it. Talk about it. You understand? Because you really feel it. And say, so, look, brother, alhamdulillah. Look, we have a masjid. Look, brother, we can make salah al-fajr. Look, we have, you understand, a class. We have somebody can teach us. And they were sitting talking something similar to what we're doing and what we're saying. Islam is a great ni'mah. And it's a big favor from Allah. And it's a selection of Allah. And like the Sahaba say, Allahumma lawla anta mahtadayna. Huh? Wala sumna wala sallayna. Oh Allah, if it's not you, okay, that we could not be guided. It's not because you're smart. How many people came out of Harvard? I just was reading something this morning about somebody, I don't want to be mentioned names, okay? And have a PhD degree and was studying in Medina and. And every day coming with something crazy. Just before Fajr, I was reading it, okay? So it's not how smart and how knowledgeable. How that Allah touched you with His mercy. That Allah selected you among millions of people. That Allah put you in the Sirat al-Mustaqim. So always, always remember the favor of Allah upon you. Not that you're strength or that you're smart. You can be continuing being selling drugs outside. But Allah put you someplace else. This is the rahmah of Allah. Allah chose, selected you. And you have to feel it. Be proud, not arrogant. Be proud with it and say, Alhamdulillah. I can be like any one of these people outside. But Alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah. That Allah made the way for us to see and to acknowledge the favor. And Allah telling us, وَأَمَّا بِنِعْمَةِ رَبِّكَ فَحَدِّثْ. With the favor of Allah, that He bless you with it, proclaim it. Talk about it. Say, Alhamdulillah. Allah bless me. Allah make me Muslim. Allah, I understand, give us a mosque in our locality that we can have a class. We can, you see, say, Alhamdulillah, brother. And showing this also in action, not only by words. So if Allah give you a masjid and you are not using the masjid, so what? If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you as imam, can give class and you are not going to the class, so what? You see? So there is a way to appreciate by tongue and there is a way to appreciate by action. So we ask that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with His greatness and with His mercy, not because we deserve it, but with His mercy, that He will include us this morning among these people, that He's proud of them and talking to the angels, look to these people. Alhamdulillah. May Allah bless us and give us always the feeling and the urge that we need to go back to the masjid again. And we need to spend some time there, 10 minutes there, reading one verse, getting a camel. Yes. This is a blessing that you feel that you always want to go back. You always want to be there. I want to make Hajj and Umrah like yesterday. We made Hajj and Umrah here. Alhamdulillah. We pray Fajr in Jama'ah and we sat in the masjid having a class and remembering Allah until sun risen. After this we pray two rak'at. So we get the reward of Hajj and Umrah inshallah. So make Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we ask Allah with His beautiful name that He make us among those people, that He proud of them, and that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep our hearts firm in this deen. Walhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. Jazakum Allah khairan. Subhanak Allah, bihamdik, nashadu an la ilaha illa anta, nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk.
Wa alaykum as-salam.
I see somebody here. One down. We need two down.
Two down, one to go.
Sorry, I got in front of you.
What's that going on?
I've been asking about you. Finally made it.
Alhamdulillah. Have a great day, everybody.
Same to you, my